Just substitute. Continuous signal is convert to discontinuous signal. Just put T is equal to NTS and then calculate the period. That's it. Not a new thing. Then energy and power part. Energy and power signals. Energy and power signal. The concept, everything is same as like you are discussed in the continuous time signal. That is energy. The small table that I have drawn up in the previous class. Final value, energy signal and power signal. Neither energy nor power signal. For this energy signal, the energy is finite and the power is zero. When the power is zero and the final value is zero, as t tending to infinity or n tending to infinity, the final value to be equal to zero. In the power signal also, energy is infinite, power is a finite value, and either t tending to infinity or n tending to infinity, the final value should be some finite value. For neither energy nor neither energy, E bar is nothing but neither energy. P bar is nothing but neither power. Neither power signal, energy is infinity, power is infinity, and the final value also is going to be infinity. This is the same concept whatever we have discussed, applicable for this one also. Now the formulas were changed. Formulas were changed in the nothing but is discontinuous. That was a continuous signal. There was an integration. This is a discontinuous signal. The integration converted into summation. In continuous signal, what is the energy of the signal? Is equal to minus infinity to infinity f square of modulus of f square of t dt. Modulus of f square of t dt. What is the power of the signal? The power of the signal is equal to integration over some period, so minus t by 2 to t by 2 f square of t dt by extending this t to up to infinity. By extending this t up to infinity, limit t tending to infinity. This is 1 by t e power minus t by 2 to t by 2 f square of t dt. Okay, in a similar way, in your discontinuous signal, this integration may convert it into the summation. So energy of the signal is equal to simply summation n equal to from minus infinity to infinity, minus infinity to infinity, f square of n. And power is summation from n equal to minus n by t to n by 2 or minus n to n, you can take minus n by 2 to n by 2. F square of n minus t by 2 f square of n, f square of n, and the width of this is equal to period of the signal is t by 2 minus or minus t by 2. Here it is 1 by 2. Here also n by 2 minus or minus 1 by 2. This is n plus that the sample value at 0 also you have to consider. So n plus 1 will appear here, extending this n to infinity. This is the power. Be careful about this plus 1 in the discontinuous signal. In the discontinuous signal, be careful about the plus 1. We have in the continuous signal, the width is from minus t to 2, 0, the value at 0 also included at that one. Here the sample values, we are considering the sample values in between minus 1 and 1. The 0 you have to take separately. This is equal to n plus 1. For example, if it is minus 1 to 1, how many samples were there here? 3 samples were there, but with the calculation this is equal to 1 minus of minus 1 is equal to 2 only, but with the calculation. But number of samples is equal to 0 equal to 1, you have to count separately. So number of samples is equal to 1. Simply the formula will become 1 by n plus 1 minus n by 2 to n by 2 f square of n. Magnitude of f square of n. It is only the difference. Everything is same. Calculate the power of the signal u of n. Calculate the power of the signal u of n. As we have calculated continuous signal, the power of signal u of t is equal to the power of the signal u of t is equal to 1 by 2 we have seen. Here we have to calculate the power of the signal u of n. The signal u of n is nothing but signal exists only for n is greater than or equal to 0 and this whole value is always 1. Always 1. For the power of, first of all, whether it is a power signal or energy signal, as n tending to infinity, there is some finite value, always constant at 1 only. As n tending to infinity, the final value of the signal is finite value, so the given signal is called is a power signal. So we can calculate the power of this, energy of the signal is infinity, of course. For the power signal, energy of the signal is infinity, of course. So energy of the signal is infinity. The power calculation for power is equal to sigma n is equal to from minus n by 2 to n by 2, or you can take this n by 2 here minus t by 2 or t by 2, this may accept all the values. Values like fraction values or integer values. Here it accepts only, the integer values, so better to consider sigma minus n to n. Minus n to n, and this will become 2n plus 1. 2n plus 1, sigma minus n to n, 1 by 2n, n tending to infinity, 1 by 2n plus 1, minus n to n. Some value, some minus n to n, n is equal to from minus n to n, it is divided by 1 by 2n plus 1 as n tending to infinity. By considering some part, I calculate in the power of that part and extending that part to up to infinity by taking limit n as n tending to infinity, will get the total power is equal to u of n, magnitude of u of n whole square. So this is equal to limit n tending infinity 1 by 2n plus 1 sigma n equal to 0 to n 1 sigma 0 to n 1 n equal to 0 to n 1. Now this value is simply equal to limit n tending to infinity, limit n tending to infinity 1 by 2n plus 1 sub sigma means summation, it is constant at 1 only, so 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus up to so on n equal to 0, this value is 1. 1 plus 1 plus up to so on n, total n plus 1 terms including n is equal to 0. So this is equal to limit n tending to infinity, limit n tending to infinity n plus 1 divided by 2n plus 1. After taking n as common, 1 plus 1 by n divided by 2 plus 1 by n, as n tending to infinity, 1 by n tending to 0, this value is equal to 1 by 2 watts. This value is equal to 1 by 2 watts. As we have seen already in the u of t, the same power, power of the signal u of t is equal to 1 by 2. Here also power of the signal is equal to 1 by 2. Next, calculate the power of the signal 1 by 2 whole to the power n u of n. Power or energy of the signal. One by two whole to the power n u of n. First of all, we have to verify the given signal is energy signal or power signal. By calculating the final value, that is the value at n equal to infinity. As n tending to infinity is 1 by 2. For example, consider log a power n into u of n. Draw the plot for a power n into u of n. If a is less than 1. a is less than 1 is nothing but it is like 0.5 or 0.1 or like that. This 0.5 increase 0.5 whole square is equal to how much? 0.25. 0.25 whole square equal to further it is 0.0625. So this value is less than 1, as increasing the power the value is going to be reduces to 0. So here as n tending to infinity, this value definitely going to be 0. At n equal to 0, this value is 1. At n equal to 2, this reduces again to 0.5. n equal to 0.25, again squaring, this becomes 0.5, further reducing. So as n tending to infinity, this value is going to be 0 for a power n into u of n. If a is greater than 1, then what will happen? If a is greater than 1, this is the plot for a power n into u of n with a is less than 1. Suppose if a is greater than 1, just I am considering that a as 5, a is equal to 5, then a square will become 25, and further squaring it will become 625. So it is so on increasing. So the corresponding plot for a power n into u of n is a to the power n into u of n is, here it is 1, after that is go on increasing to infinity. This is the plot for the a power n into u of n, and the corresponding plot in the continuous signal is the e to the power minus t into u of t, this one, and for this one the corresponding plot is the e to the power at into u of t. In e power minus at u of t, the plot is like this, at going to infinity is going to be 0. The similar fashion is a power n into u of n with a is less than 1. In your continuous signal, e power at into u of t, as t tending to infinity, this will goes to infinity. The corresponding signal in the discrete is the a power n into u of n with a is greater than 1. So, in our question, what is the energy or power of the signal? 1 by 2 whole to the power n u of n. It is looks like a power n into u of n. Here a is equal to 1 by 2, which is less than 1. So as n tending to infinity, the final value definitely will become 0. So you can call the given signal is the energy signal. Given signal is the energy signal. Calculate the energy of this signal is equal to sigma n is equal to from minus infinity to infinity. Sigma n is from minus infinity to infinity. 1 by 2 n into u of n whole square. And whole square. As we have u of n exist only for the positive values of time. So it will become n equal to 0 to infinity. 1 by 2 power n whole square. So this is simply equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity. 1 by 2 whole to the power 2 n or 1 by 4. Whole to the power n, 1 by 4 whole to the power n, this is equal to 1 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 whole square plus 1 by 4 whole cube. It is sum of infinity series. In the first class we have seen the formula for this one. This is equal to a by 1 minus r, first term by common ratio. This is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus 1 by 4, which is equal to 4 by 3 joules. This is equal to 4 by 3 joules. Then next, what is the energy or power of the signal? N into u of n. N into u of n. You can call this as the ramp signal. Okay, we have seen the power energy or power of the signal T into u of t. T into of t. Before calculation, first of all, you have to verify the given signal is the energy signal or power signal by estimating the value of this as n tending to infinity. Here n into u of n, this is a ramp signal as it is. This is equal to some function f of n they have given. F of 0 is equal to 0, f of 0 is equal to 0, and f of 1 is equal to 1 into u of n. U of n is always 1 only, 1 into 1 that is 1. And f of 2 is equal to 2, f of 3 is equal to 3, f of 3 equal to 4. As n tending to infinity, the final value will become infinity. As the final value is going to be infinity, the corresponding signal can be treated as a neither energy nor power signal. Then next one, consider the energy or power of the signal R of n minus R of n minus 4. Find the energy or power of the signal R of n minus 4, where R of n is the ramp signal. Whereas R of n is the ramp signal. Here we have considered the ramp signal n into u of n is the neither energy nor power signal. Here it may be energy or power or neither energy nor power. We have to draw the plot for this signal. R of n minus R of n minus 4. R of n is nothing but simply n equal to 0, 0, n equal to 1, 1, n equal to 2, 2, n equal to 3, 3, n equal to 4, 4, and n equal to 5, 5, like that. Then R of n minus 4, simply shifted version of this R of n only. N minus 4 equal to 0, n equal to 4. Add this 4 to the each and every intervals of R of n. So it should start n equal to 4, this value is 0. N equal to 4, this value is 0. And n equal to 5, this value is 1. N equal to 6, this value is 2. Here it is 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Here it is 1, 2, 3, like that we will get 5. This much information is enough. Then 7, 8, like that. The resultant signal is the R of n minus R of n minus 4. R of n minus 4. Up to 4, the sample values are 0. So it will come as it easily. Up to sample value is 1, sample value is 2, sample value is 3, sample value is 4. At n equal to 4. Now at n equal to 5, this value is 5, and 5 minus 1, this value is 4 at n equal to 5. Then 6 minus 2, so 4 only. Then 7 minus 3, 4 only. 8 minus 4, 4 only. So this value is constant at n equal to 4 as n is going on to be infinity. So final value is going to be finite value as n tending to infinity. So we can say the given signal is the power signal. Given signal is the power signal, and calculate the power of this signal. Then calculate the power of this signal. How can you calculate the direct formula? Limit n tending to infinity 1 by 2n plus 1 sigma n is equal to minus n to n f of n whole square. F of n whole square. Here the signal exists only for the positive, only for the positive values. So we can only for the positive values. So we can consider from 0 to infinity. From 0 to infinity. Try to solve. Zero to infinity is equal to sim limit n tending to infinity 1 by 2 n plus 1 sigma n is equal to 0 to n f of n whole square. So this can be represented as up to 3, this value is 1, 2, 3, 1 plus 2 plus, oh sorry, 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square, 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus sigma n is equal to 4 to capital N 4 square, capital N 4 square. So this is equal to 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus this value, how much is this value? Total is 1 by 2 N plus 1 as n tending to infinity, as n tending to infinity. 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus 4 square into 16. 16 into how many values are there? From 4 to n. If suppose from 4 to 7, how many will there? 4, 5, 6, 7. If 4 to 7, then 4, 5, 6, 7. How many 4 values are there? If 4 to 10, then 10 minus 4 plus 1. 7 values will be there. Here how many? N minus 4 plus 1. This much of values will be exist. Got it? From suppose sigma n equal to 4 to 6. N is equal to 4 to 6 they have given. Then how many values? 4, 5 and 6. 4, 5 and 6. How many here? 4, 1, 2, 3. That is 6 minus 4 plus 1. 6 minus 4 plus 1. Suppose they are from 4 to 10. Then 10 minus 4 plus 1. 10 minus 4, 6 plus 1. 7 values will reach. So here n equal to 4 from n. So there should be n minus 4 plus 1. This much of samples may exist. N minus 4 plus 1 divided by 2n plus 1 with n tending to infinity. N tending to infinity. This value is 3 square 9 plus 4 plus 1. 9 plus 4 plus 1, that is 14. That is 14, whatever, 14 divided by 2n plus 1. As n tending to infinity, this value may become 0. This value may become 0. So this is equal to 0 plus 16 into n minus 3 divided by 2n plus 1 as limit n tending to infinity. N tending to infinity by taking 16 as common in number and 2 as common in the denominator. So this will get 8. This will get 8. Then what is the energy or power of the signal? 1 by 2 whole to the power n, 1 by 2 whole to the power n u of minus n minus 1, 1 by 2 whole to the power n u of minus n minus 1. First, see, in the continuous signal, the step signal is u of t, which is for the, but representing the positive side of the t value, positive side of the t value. The corresponding signal to represent the negative side of the two values is u of minus t. U of t is like this one, and u of minus t is this one. U of minus t is this one. Whereas in discontinuous signal, this u of n is equal to 1, 1, 1, 1, like that. And this is the u of n, your signal along with n equal to 0 on the positive side of this time. Positive side of this one. The corresponding negative side of this signal is starts from minus 1, not including the 0. 0 was already available in the u of n. So this 0 is not to be available here. This will represent the negative part of the negative time part of the discontinuous signal. How can you represent this signal? This signal is simply u of n minus 1 is equal to, you write u of n minus 1. U of n minus 1 is starts from 1. This is your u of n minus 1. The signal, we want a signal from minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, like that. Here we have the signal from 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. How can you convert this 1, 2 becomes as a minus 1, 2 will become minus 2, 3 will become minus 3. How good will become? By multiplying these values with the minus 1. With the minus 1. So if you write this f of minus n minus 1, the corresponding signal will become like this. U of minus n minus 1. So in the question, if they mention u of minus n minus 1 is nothing but they are concentrating on the negative values of the time domain, negative values of the, that is left side of the left side of the t n equal to 0, they are concentrating. So 1 by 2 whole n into u of minus n minus 1, indication is like that. From this, write down one question, u of t plus u of minus t equal to how much, and u of n plus u of minus n equal to how much. U of t plus u of minus t is nothing but just combining these two. Here the value is 1, here the value is 1, and combining these two we get the DC signal whose value is equal to 1. Now coming to this one, u of n plus u of minus 1 they are asking. U of n is nothing but here this one only. This is your u of n. Whatever this u of minus n, minus n is equal to 1, n equal to minus 1, multiply that minus 1 with the each and every intervals of the time. So this we will get like this. 0 also will appear here. When combining these two, u of n plus u of minus n, which is equal to 1, plus one more sample will be exist, which is equal to computed as a del of n. Because at n equal to 0, we have 2. 1 plus 1, 2. Value of sample is 2. And one sample is considering as a throw, 1, 1, 1, that is 1. Plus the another sample value is considering that as a del of n. It is equal to 1 plus del of n, not 1 only. It is 1. When will become 1? U of n plus u of minus n minus 1 is equal to 1. Because u of n is the sample values of this one, and u of minus 1 minus 1 is the sample values of this one. And combining these two, you have 1 throughout the from minus infinity to infinity, that is DC signal. This is also one topic you have to remember. Next thing, here is the question. 1 by 2 whole to the power n into u of minus n minus 1, and what is the energy of the signal? 2 to the power n into u of minus n minus 1. 2 to the power of n into u of minus n minus 1. Here we are concentrating on the negative values of the time. So n is the negative value. So it will become 1 by 2 whole to the power negative values. So as n tending to infinity, the value is equal to 1 by 2 whole to the power minus infinity. 1 by 2 whole to the power minus infinity. This is equal to 2 to the power infinity. This value is equal to infinity. Earlier we have done a question, that is 1 by 2 whole to the power n into u of n. That was the positive values of the time. Final value is, as n tending to infinity, 1 by 2 whole to the power infinity, this value is equal to 0 at that time. Here the negative values, as n tending to infinity, 1 by 2 whole to the power minus infinity is infinity here. So this is a neither energy nor power signal. Final value going to infinity, this will become neither energy nor power signal. Coming to this value, 2 power n into u of minus n minus 1, as n tending to infinity is nothing but minus infinity, because we are concentrating on the negative values of time. So here it is, as n tending to infinity, this will become 2 to the power minus infinity, that is 1 by 2 whole to the power infinity. This value may become equal to 0. So this representation of this is like this. Finally it goes to 0. But here it is 1, and going on increasing to infinity. So this is the neither energy nor power signal. Here as n tends to infinity, this going on decreases to 0. So this can be treated as a which signal? Definitely it is an energy signal. And we can calculate, the formula is sigma n equal to from minus infinity to infinity f of n whole square. This is equal to 2 power n u of minus n minus 1 whole square. As it is exist only for the negative values of time, we can consider this equal to minus infinity to 0. Minus infinity to 0, 2 to the power 2n. This is exist for the minus negative values. So first value is equal to minus infinity to minus 1. Minus infinity to minus 1, 2 to the power 2n. First value is equal to 2 to the power minus 2, 2 to the power minus 2, plus 2 to the power minus 4 plus 2 to the power minus 8 plus up to so on 2 to the 0, that is up to so on infinity, 2 to the power minus infinity, up to so on infinity. This is our geometric progression only. The first term divided by 1 minus common ratio. First term here is equal to 2 to the power minus 2 divided by common ratio equal to second term divided by first term, which is equal to 2 power minus 2 only. This is 1 minus common ratio 2 power minus 2. So 1 by 4 divided by 1 minus 1 by 4, this is equal to 1 by 3. Right. This is equal to 1 by 3. Not equation t equal to 0, because of this go of minus and minus 1, it should start from 1, it should start from minus 1, minus 1. Then next goes. Given x of n is equal to given x of n is equal to n square per 0 less than or equal to n less than or equal to 3, this equal to 10 minus n, 4 less than or equal to n less than or equal to 6, and this equal to n, 7 less than or equal to n less than or equal to 9, then equal to 0 otherwise. Calculate the energy or power of the signal. If it is energy signal, calculate the energy. If it is power signal, calculate the power. First, examine whether the given signal is the energy signal or power signal. Whether the given signal is the energy signal or power signal. Then next one, you calculate the energy of the signal. First, try to do the power. Cos. Okay, here first of all, we analyze the energy or power of the signal. We have to get the idea about the final value of the given signal. What is the final value of the given signal given? For different intervals, they have given. From 0 to 3, they are concentrating on the positive side. In negative side, they did not mention. So, they are concentrating mainly on the positive side. First of all, they concluded about that. From 0 to 3 given, 4 to 6 is given. 4 to 6 is given. 7 to 9 is given. 7 to 9 is given. Other values after 9, this value is 0. That is, as n tending to infinity, we can conclude this value is equal to 0. So, we can call this as the energy signal. Then, we can calculate the energy of the signal. That energy of the signal E is equal to simply summation minus n to minus infinity to infinity. So, this is from 0 to infinity. That is, we can exist only from 0 to 9. So, you can take up to 0 to 9. Sigma n is equal to from 0 to 9 x of n whole square. Magnitude of x of n whole square. So this is equal to sigma n is equal to 0 to 9 up to n equal to 0 to 3. This value is n square. This value is n square up to 0 to 3. So this is equal to sigma n equal to 0 to 3. You can call this equal to n square whole square. N square whole square plus sigma n equal to 4 to 6. This value is 10 minus n whole square. Plus sigma n is equal to 7 to 9. This value is n, that is n square. This is n square. So this value is equal to n to the power 4, 1 power 4 plus 2 power 4 plus 3 to the power 4 plus this is 10 minus n whole square. First n equal to 1, 10 minus 4, that is 6 square. Plus n, if n equal to 5, 5 square. If n equal to 6, 4 square. Plus 7 to 9, this value is 7 square plus 8 square plus 9 square, whatever the value you will get, that will be the corresponding energy of the given signal. The energy of the given signal. Next, this one. Find the energy of the signal cos pi n by 3, cos pi n by 3 u of n minus 6. Here. Cos pi n by 3 u of n minus 6. First of all, examine whether the given signal is an energy or power signal. Energy or power signal. The cosine signal, of course, it is a power signal, but it is exist only for the particular region from U of n minus 6. U of n minus 6 is nothing but from n equal to 0 to 5 only it is exist. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Up to 0 to 5 only this exists. So the final value of the signal is equal to 0. We can conclude this is the energy signal. So we have to calculate the power of energy of this signal. We have to calculate the energy of this signal. It is simply sigma n is equal to 0 to 5. Sigma n equal to 0 to 5 cos square pi n by 3. So this is equal to, if n is equal to 0, cos 0 is equal to 1. So 1 plus, if n is equal to 1, cos square pi by 3. Cos square pi by 3. Cos pi by 3 means cos 60. Cos 60 means 1 by 2, so 1 by 4. Plus n equal to 2, cos 2 pi by 3. Cos 2 pi by 3, because whatever, negative or positive, because of this way, it will be positive only. This is also 1 by 4. This is also 1 by 4. And this is also 1 by 4. N equal to 0, n equal to 1, n equal to 2. N equal to 0, n equal to 1, 2, 3, n equal to 4, and n equal to 5. Whatever the answer you will get, that will be the energy of the signal. First of all, the concept here is that in the continuous time signal also we have to identify the given signal is energy signal or power signal. Just keep the table in our mind. We can get the value. First get the idea about the final value of the signal. If the final value is 0, the corresponding signal will be energy signal. If the final value is finite, the corresponding signal will be power signal. The final value is infinite, the corresponding is the neither energy nor power signal. Then consider this is the end of the basic operations of the signals. Just till now we have seen that about the continuous signal and about the discontinuous signal and about the discontinuous signal. Operations on the signal, shifting, scaling. The important point keep in our mind is that scaling should be followed. The combination of shifting and scaling, you have to do shifting, then scaling. Then scaling for shifting, just equate to 0 and add the corresponding value of time to the all intervals of the time. And if the scaling, just equate to 1 and multiply the required value of t to 1. After completion of the scaling and shifting, we have seen. The periodicity, energy, even and R component, and energy and power of the signal. Next one is that the class number 2. This is about the systems. System is not a new thing. This is also a signal. That's it. This is also a signal system. I am considering this also. System is nothing but you are sending some signal x of t to the system to getting the output y of t. Here the signal is representing as x of t only. System also is signal only, not a new thing. We are calling this a system because it is giving some operation. It is performing some operations on the input signal to produce the output signal. So we are calling that as a system. System is also signal only, whose signal representation is our h of t. And the corresponding output is y of t. We have to analyze the nature of the system here. In this concept, in this discussion, we have to analyze the nature of the system. Whether the given system is linear or non-linear. Whether the given system is time invariant or time variant. Whether the given signal is causal or non-causal. Whether the given system is stable or not stable. Stable or unstable. Whether the given signal is static or dynamic. Whether the given signal is invertible or non-invertible. And finally, what is the response of the system? How can you calculate the response of the system? That is convolution. And some properties of the convolution. This belongs to the class 2 session. The system is a new thing. System is also a signal only. Which of the we have to analyze the nature of the system here. We will discuss each and every one very clearly. These are very, very important examination point of view. It is not a new thing. There is no formulas or nothing. Just keep your mind about the concept. about the concept. But if you have about the linearity or non-linearity, very very important. They will give you some system h of t, they will give you or the directly they will give you the system, or they will give you the relation in the form of y of t and x of t. Y of t and x of t, y of relation between y of t and x of t is given is nothing but indirectly they have given the given about the system only. Like from the given analysis, we have to identify linearity or non-linearity, time invariant, time variant, causality, stability, static or dynamic, invertibility, and finally, what is the response of the system y of t if we give x of t as the input to the system? That is the convolution. The convolution we will see. Right.